I'm sitting in a scooby chair. Dealing with something in my body. That's number one. Number two, I'm dealing with my career situation, my job situation, my partner situation, my financial situation. That's number two. And number three, like, what am I dealing with spiritually? Well, I'm going to put my spiritual life. Or I have a solo or producer this week. So that's my career right there. As far as what I'm doing with my body, you know, I'm really angry about speeches that come like, okay, God, why are you insisting on attacking my body? Why are you insisting on attacking my body? You know, one thing is I can comment on it is everyone is watching me have aspiration. And they're watching my personal life. And they are actually acting out my personal life. And then looking at me and laughing at what I can't do. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know my personal life was that intriguing. If I had thought it was something I wanted, I probably would have went in another direction. But I thought of one point in heaven. And speaking of heaven, let's get to hell. So intriguing. He's definitely, you know, someone is watching her. Some of my parents are watching her. Wish for something and find it in my personal life. Here's something. They watch her wish for something in her personal life, and she found it in my personal life. And that's something. And found something in my personal life. Isn't that something? But what I'm trying to work on is immediate avenue of income here. And so many people reach out to me without actually a personal involvement. And so many people reach out to me without a personal involvement, but it meant a lot to me. It meant a lot to me. They had a heart good enough to reach out to me. But you know, like I said, I'm angry with God because I don't know what the insistence upon attacking my body during this time. I'm very angry about that. You know, I hope that in the judgment comes, that's very severe. I have to be honest. I hope that in judgment comes, that's very severe. You know what I'm saying? I hope we go down to the 10th level of here to the darkest place, where the most filthiest beings and stay there forever. In hell, we will never see the 10th level of hell. The hottest, darkest, filthiest part of hell. That's my hope for you. Because he is choosing to attack my body to show me. So now I don't care about it anyway. But did want to say something here. I can't believe what's happened to my body, but I should have known that whatever this is, the purpose was nothing good. Whatever this is, the purpose was nothing good. I was at the cottage, hanging out, and going and signing up, identifying yourself with your state, HIV. And you can, you know, use the Wi-Fi and use their computers for a limited time. They only have so many, so it's open to the public. You have to let other guests in. Unless you have a laptop, use the Wi-Fi and work. You can work and use their library. You can use their research all day if you want to research. But right now, and I was there last week, and I can briefly describe the symptoms I described to the doctor initially. And she swear to God, she didn't take blood. She didn't take. She referred me to a She took blood, she took my body sign. Another comeback. She took, she went up in my, she sent me to kind of ultrasound, some like petty going x-ray or do some kind of ultrasound inside my body. With the other woman, thank God I told her. Girl sticks up in my vagina and go do all kind of sound and come back and tell me that the line in my vagina is a little big and they want to take a biopsy. The fucking biopsy. The fucking vagina. I'm telling you that. It's a horrifying symptom when somebody put something in my body and I was beginning to do shit to me. I'm telling you, when you talking about you were finding a genetic stool sample and all kind of shit, it's what a God and she find it. So they refer me to all kinds of special. I don't think that these motherfuckers like that great girl. I do have to go to the statistics and go behind me. I'm gonna get that. I'm trying to charge my phone as well. I'm trying to charge. I'm making a video. It's taking that little bit of charge that I have. So let me tell you what happened. I went to the college. And, I'll tell you something. I don't know how to describe it, what I'm dealing with, but you know, come out my mind, and I couldn't see it. But then, as I walked through the automatic door, then about a couple of doors away, the door opened, but you didn't see it. To open the door. So I'm going to go to the bathroom on one of these public places, whether it be the college or the store. I stop the door open. I understand the closed environment. You have enough density to have the hand on the drying machine, have the hand towels come out, and you have to put your hand in front of the towel to automatically roll up. The thing just be rolling. Just be rolling when I'm in the bathroom. And this is some terrifying shit. I'm keeping in mind, my Bible says, fear the fear for an unbelievable burning the lake of fire for him. This is terrifying shit, but what I do is I begin to confess the word of God. I begin to kind of recite the word of God, the Lord is my life, my salvation. The angel of the Lord encamp around those who fear him and defend him. I begin to recite the word of God that we that's how I deal with the fear. If I say the fear for me, I'm believing you will burn me and make up. So I think my name is shit. It's scary as a motherfucker. If it's scary. Choose to have in faith that whatever you're dealing with, that the word of God will override all of that. By faith. And so I think that it's not that it's fearful. Let me mean it. But choose to act in faith. I said the fearful and unbelieving in the book of Revelation, burning in the fire. So you can't just let somebody terrify you into a corner. To bury your head in this thing. But so I left the college last week with this thing, with the mindset, with the door opening, whatever you need, like if not this, but if this enough to cause these things to yeah. So that's how I don't know what happened or what is the thing why somebody said they had a couple of born on though, but I don't watch TV, so I probably get in time. But, you know, I have the alerts on my phone, so I don't know if they issue those kind of alerts in the emission or the system where it comes in and fall. Now, after being out, I'm going to say, I don't know what I did. I don't know where it came from. I suspect there's something important because something happened at work. I've been going through a health thing where been making myself drink a gallon of water while I'm sitting at my desk. So I had a gallon of water. I said, my thing that will save me to this time. I had a gallon of water. I drank a gallon of four. I had 4 pounds of 3 ounces of water. That would buy your morning in the store and put on my desk and drink those 4 pounds of water. And, to equalize to a gallon. I would do that every day while I'm sitting. I think that was because when I got up to go to New York, I went to call where I went by step away from my desk break when I come in. And I began to choke when I sit by my coffee cup. I felt the want to regurgitate my food by sticking it by my coffee. I tried, but nothing happened. So it scared me, but I said, well, you know, I don't know what I'm dealing with. So I go to the hospital. They do. They take my body, I take blood, and send me home. Then I start to feel like my stomach's crawling all over. And so I said, whatever it was, it's crawling all over. And it's supposed to kill me. But because I had so much water in my body, it starts to come out. So I don't know what I'm doing with it. I'm going to the doctor and going to the doctor and they do the same thing. Take blood, take vitamins, and say no. Take blood, take vitamins, and say no. So I went to the doctor and I said, you know, this is what I'm dealing with. She didn't tell me I have a crazy. I think I'm going crazy. She referred me to the mental thing. So I didn't take none of that mental shit. I didn't go to none of it. I didn't deal with none of it. I'm not taking the medication. It's not normal. I'm telling you, things happen to me. I changed after I go to New York. She said, I get fine, and she take all kind of school stuff. And I came and I'm looking at this lady and wondering what the hell she doing. And somebody paid her not to treat me, but not to find something. But she knows what it is and refused to treat it. Because she know what it is. She, I think she's from here. And I'm accusing about me because I don't know. So I go back to the college today after not going for the weekend. And after having that phenomenon happen, no one to tell up. With no one to tell up. And nowhere to go and know what to do. So I go back and it's all kind of droppings. All kind of droppings covering the courtyard. When I sit down, it's all kind of unbelievable dropping out in that courtyard. So I guess people walking out, they have no concern what it is, what it could be. But I'm wondering myself, what is that? Some of the dramas are dry, some of them are bright, as if it's even old. Some of them are brown. So I'm like, what is that? All these people dropping out here. So I go up back to my car, and last time, I figured the janitor. We have fresh green droppings. Fresh green droppings. There's no pests. No, I see no dogs nowhere. I never seen it with a squirrel or a bird. So I wonder what that is. After I had left that weekend, it's getting very terrifying. And it get for me. So I was in my car this morning. I let the windows down. And I turned the air on. I want to be in that closed space. So I walk. The window was sitting by the nigga all the time. And I began to smell something that I never smelled before. But it was so smelly. It was unbelievable. Not really like a garbage truck or dropping smell. It was an unbelievable smell. And it was very intense, very pungent, very intense. That's a very hard time. And my chest said, "Mom, what's that smell? Is that you? I never had all in my life." And as we passed by, the odor was in the face. So I don't know what that smell was, but God forbid it was something that had come out of my body. And God forbid. I'm still watching my hair at least 4 or 5 times a day. Still washing my hair. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna go get a bug. I'm gonna go get this bug. That's not know what's gonna happen. I'm not prepared for it to die. We need to lay in the bed like Isaac. Just release my ghost up as I go to sleep. I prefer to pray. I'm saying that to say in the Bible, it's a long life you're blessing me to you. I say it's nothing too hard for you, don't worry. I say the angel of the Lord kept on those who fear and deliver them. I say the angel of mercy, spirit sent a message of someone in here is salvation. Now, I wonder what happened if I see you. Well, the angel will come right back with God that I'm having what you're doing in my body. And I tell him like that, I'm kidding. I say, God, tell him like that, I'm kidding. If I could see, I'm kidding. I tell him like that. Maybe I'm hot. Maybe it's spiritual life. I'm just spiritual. And you curse by me anyway, even if you're justified, then you can damn your soul. So, at the end of the day, you know, God is telling me that I'm saying, I don't know if I'm prepared to get into those things that God is telling me. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to prepare to get into those things. But I may touch on it. Let me tell you that the reason that the white and she's trying to tell a black woman, a dark woman, that she had value by attacking someone, a dark woman, is an Indian. Now, I don't know what somebody may have seen me. Hey, it's you. Now come here. We bitches and that shit. And I have a back day answer. I just white people ain't gonna run back in the motherfucker. Man. So I put me in my place. But I feel that's the way I feel. You're not gonna change the way I feel. By trying to intimidate me. I'm going to change what I feel. I'm not going to violate your personality. I appreciate you when you're mine. That's my feeling. I hate, you know, black people are accusing my racism. You're violating people's personal space. Respect me, respect that. If nobody wants you in their personal space, get the fuck out. And respect that. Go meet somebody who wants you in their personal space. Go meet some other people, you know. But, thing. That's what God said to me. He wants one black woman back. Now, God said he don't judge that black woman. But she required somebody to be hurt for sure that she's bad. But I said a white woman is saying she's bad. You know what I think? I think a white woman don't want to pay. She won't pay. She won't pay. She don't want to pay. She can't afford to pay. You're not gonna pay a woman to stay on the corner more than, you know, I don't know what she's doing. You know, because you know she's laying thousands of dollars that week. Or that month, hundreds of dollars that week or that month, I'm not sure. But a woman that is attractive and decent and clean and attractive, and you wanna have her as a friend, as a good benefit, then you're gonna give her something. She's telling that black woman that she got her by her, but she don't want to pay nobody for a woman. She don't want to pay for a decent woman. Pay for a cat woman, a decent cat woman. And if that woman is sitting there playing games and they might play games, what they're doing is they're wanting people to have a way to connect. That's a way to connect. That's a way to communicate with each other. And that's what they're doing. They are not showing anybody a bad woman. And I said, black women don't have. Get high, pay if they're a cat. I'm just saying, one standing on a corner, the service they have in the jar the week or month, they're not going to get any money, not that money that she's going to get put on the corner. And whatever color she might be. But, and I don't touch on this, nothing I care about, nothing. I see myself as a tribe for being mine. Say mind, body, tongue, spirit. Well, I said that. In the day that you eat the food, you're going to die. What's going to die your body? I said, you give me 8 months. And you begin to take on sickness and you begin to die. So these bodies going to die. When the Bible said that we're going to receive new bodies. These are people that's going to hear us out. We're going to hear us out. We're going to receive new bodies. You know, new bodies will be glorified by. I mean, they're not going to age, they're not going to die. And it's because yeah, we will hear a salvation every time. So, I don't see myself as, I don't identify myself in that manner as a color or race. I'm not saying I'm not a black American citizen. According to my identity, but what I'm saying, I don't value myself. I don't base my worth on you saying, well, as a black woman compared to a white woman, this is your black. Well, in America, that may be the case. On earth, that may be. That's the reality. That's a fact. That's the truth. But you're not going to put my mind in a box and make me live in it. And maybe it's just that box. Oh, your definition wise, you know, I'm going to have the fullness of what the Bible says I can have. Now, I'm saying I'm standing the word is very terrifying. Very terrifying what I'm doing. It's very terrifying. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know what I thought I was going to happen. But I didn't think this was going to happen. Put a little less on my hair today. In that chemical house to remove some of what that is. Some of it. Even just a little bit of it's really. Even just a little bit of it's really. I put that chemical on my hair today after 2 weeks, put it on 2 weeks ago. It didn't burn as bad because I went ahead and basted it this time. So it didn't burn as bad, so I have to cover it up with a scarf. What's going to happen next? But I'm too I refuse to walk in fear. I refuse to walk in fear. You know, when we went to campus and the motion hands into a new class, the door was opening, we couldn't see it. The door was open, we couldn't see nothing. Yesterday it was opening. And now there's all these strange rocks there, but you see no animal there, they're putting it there. So that's the way something will happen with, but more truth to God and move forward. And hopefully I will get my children to a place where if things that work out the way I would like to, I will continue to God as a woman. Bless me, show me this, and if they don't work out the way I would like to, then I will get my children to a place. They don't need anything from anybody. They can't have a home, they can't have peace in their home. I want to trust God. I need to get in faith in my home, because I can sense a personality, that's the system of your personality. Rejoicing for whatever we are not sure what's you rejoicing about. I'm sensing this in every personality. But it's not my concern, you know, what they're rejoicing about. I'm okay. It made me angry. I have to get on the internet in my business. But like I said, my spiritual walk is not where it needs to be, so I don't understand what I'm doing. I have to get on the internet. What's the thing? What you want that word? And I'm tired of something. When I first started work, I was 16, but I didn't tire. I started when I was 18 on my own. Even though my mom had been giving since I was a little girl, I remember clearly that I wanted to get to church. But I never did it myself until I was 18 years old. Even when I started working, I was 16. So I'm tired of running 7 o'clock. Bless me financially. I can live quietly to myself. And then I said, well, I don't know what's happening. Give me an offer, my own offer. Being constantly attacked and placing from me in my own office. I'm sitting outside my office. Suddenly, a big move to a closing at 5 a.m. I'm sitting outside my office. Verbally attacked my daughter. She's coming and going. Go outside. This woman is literally walking back and forth like a gorilla ready to attack. You know what she is mad about? I have no idea what she's looking at her for and what she's saying to her. Just walking back and forth like a gorilla. I said, my God. I wish I would have came outside when she told me that the woman bought her. I have no idea what she was saying to me. I said, well, just enough. So they wouldn't let me work on my son. I said, well, I don't know what I'm dealing with, but I do believe what I have to be. I'm being on the TV. I'm not a singer, I'm not a dancer. I do a little comedy. I don't feel like it right now. I do a little comedy. And I write. So I haven't been to do something in the entertainment. I'm trying to go ahead and do that because I feel my hand being forced. I want to be quiet, a little quieter, but I feel my hands being forced. I'm going to go ahead and try to make this nothing more to me, nothing more than a way to earn income, make a profit, money. Listen, that may be everything to someone. It may be everything to someone other than being famous. I see that man killing himself after he lost the piece of TV show. This little piece of TV show. I must have meant so much to him because he killed himself when he was old. Little piece of TV show, I believe. And definitely get when you beg your way into somebody else's stuff and you don't write your own destiny. And again, an attack is on my body, but it's really about them. I said, what are you doing, God? It's terrifying what I'm feeling right now. It's terrifying. but I'm gonna speak the word and I'm gonna continue to try to finish this project that I work on. And hopefully, I will have something on the release real soon. Beside the book, you know, beside the book. Here, self-publishing is the thing to do. It's been very lucrative for some. With this book I'm working on, but hopefully one day it's green. I can make some revenue off of that real soon as well. Not because I'm not finished, not because it's not interesting, not because I'm going to report to that. I don't know. I'm really dealing with some revenue. I'm telling this person, I feel like thank you might be more than one. And I'm going to sound like, oh, Cynthia, thank you, Spirit, for that. But I'm sensing this person that, and it's something very important. I have not been. Say all that bullshit yesterday is very fine today. And I really didn't think I would have come on the same house with bullshit, but soon I said, I don't know why. I don't know if another person that's just watching me. Any bullshit. I don't know to watch it. So I said, I don't know why I began to feel it. And I started in a very terrifying situation in my body. It's unbelievable. I let go, I don't know what to do. I'm going to continue to confess the word. I'm continuing to confess the word. At the very least, I think my choice. Stay in the house. Be in the house, and I'm going to come out of the trial. And, you know, I don't know. Part of what I'm dealing with, I'm not getting this sleep, but it haunts this thing. And I'm going to describe the terrifying experience that I had when I'm trying to sleep. And so, usually, the person attacking me. So, when my body's attacking me, the person is attacking me. It's unbelievable. And then the motherfucking mind play games with her. And that's the thing that white people put her in where she is. And white people put her where she is. Basically saying that sin about sin, this is not real. I'm just saying she's not my mind, they're taking my mind, they're taking my mind right now. But saying she's about sin, it's not real. But, you know, my heart goes out to her. My heart goes out to her. I do plan to make a professional persona for my company that I'm planning.